Hello everyone, raise your hands if you're a Sabudana Kheer lover, because I am one. I've always been fascinated with this kheer because of this beautiful tiny little pearls that float about merrily in milk that has been reduced. This has always been my favorite kheer and it still is one of my top go-to desserts when there is guests at home. So today I'm going to show you how to make lump-free Sabudana Kheer. To begin with, let us talk about the soaking process. Today, I'm going to take 3 tablespoons of Sabudana and soak it for 4 hours for making this kheer. The reason why you're seeing more Sabudana here is because I have soaked the quantity required for my Sabudana Khichdi and for my kheer. So once the Sabudana is soaked, it all becomes squishy and it doubles up in volume. So essentially, 3 tablespoons of Sabudana when soaked will double up to half a cup of Sabudana. Now the first step we are going to do is cook this Sabudana. I have added 2 cups of water to a saucepan. Now I am going to be taking half a cup of soaked Sabudana. Like I mentioned, if you use 3 tablespoons of Sabudana, cover it with enough water just to immerse it and soak it for 4 hours. Then it would have doubled and it will roughly give you half a cup of soaked Sabudana. Now, what we are going to do is, we are going to boil or rather cook the Sabudana in water for 8 minutes till the balls become transparent. Now, if you can see, as and when the Sabudana cooks, it slowly rises to the top and it begins floating on the top. Now, if you can see, the Sabudana has become all cooked and the pearls have turned transparent. And you can also see that the water which was clear before has become very murky. This means that the starch from the Sabudana has been separated out into the water. Now I have strained the Sabudana and I am adding it back to the saucepan. To this I am going to be adding 2 cups of boiled milk. I am using full fat milk here today. When I say 2 cups, it's approximately 400 ml. Once you add the milk, we are going to further cook these Sabudana pearls in the milk until the milk reduces in volume a little bit. We are not going to thicken our milk today like we would do for a traditional pal payasam. Now I am adding 2 green cardamoms which has been crushed using a mortar and pestle. Now once the cardamom has been added, give it a good stir and we are going to continue cooking our Sabudana in this milk for about 5 to 7 minutes. Now, if you want lump-free, non-sticky Sabudana kheer, then what you're supposed to be doing is you're supposed to be reducing the amount of Sabudana that you use in the kheer. The reason why I'm saying this is because if you add too much of Sabudana, then the ratio of Sabudana and milk becomes almost equal because Sabudana has the tendency to double up. So you keep the Sabudana on the lower side and you increase the quantity of the milk to get a non-sticky and non-lumpy Sabudana kheer. If you can see, the milk has come to a good frothy rolling boil now. Another tip that I want to include at this point is make sure that you keep stirring your Sabudana while you cook it in water or in milk. This is to prevent the balls going and settling down at the bottom and also to prevent them from burning. So now if you can see, our milk has boiled, our Sabudana has been cooked. We will add 1/4 cup of sugar. Again, you can adjust the quantity of sugar as per your sweet requirements. Remember friends, if you add sugar before this stage, then the Sabudana wouldn't have absorbed the milk and it wouldn't cook properly. Now that I've added the sugar, I'm going to mix it and I'm going to let it simmer till the sugar is all dissolved and I'm going to let it reduce a little bit more. If you can see in the pan, the quantity of the milk has reduced slightly. Again, like I said, we are not going to reduce the milk to half or 1/3 of its volume like we would do in a traditional pal payasam. So now our Sabudana has completely cooked and let us get on to our next step, which is adding raisins and cashews. I'm going to fry them in ghee today. I've taken 2 teaspoons of ghee and once the ghee melted, I'm adding 12 halves of cashews. Let us fry this on low to medium flame till the cashews begin to turn golden. Exactly at that time, let us add 2 tablespoons of raisins and once the raisins puff up, let us switch off the flame and transfer all the raisins and cashews along with the ghee into the kheer. Now, you can see that the raisins are puffing up. So, this is the correct stage to switch off the flame. And we are going to add, like I said, the ghee and the cashews, raisins to the kheer. And let's mix it up. You could stop at this stage, but I like to do one more round of simmering just for the ghee's flavor to be well incorporated into our kheer. So I'm going to put back the saucepan on the flame and I'm going to simmer it for 3 minutes on low to medium flame, stirring occasionally, just like I said, to ensure that the Sabudana pearls do not settle down at the bottom. So that's it, my dear lovely friends. Our Savan Wala special, Vrat Ka special Sabudana Kheer is ready. I'm first going to offer this as a prasadam to God. For more recipes, please visit tomatoblues.com. If you enjoyed watching this video, do not forget to hit the like button, leave a comment, share this video with your family and friends, and subscribe to our channel. Do not forget to hit the bell icon next to the subscribe button for more updates from Tomato Blues channel and from the Tomato Blues website. Thank you for watching this video, my dear friends. We'll see you all again soon in another video. Till then, take care, stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye.